Thou dost rise from the tomb, O Christ Savior, our God, because thou art deathless, and thou didst raise with thee thy rule by thy resurrection, and didst crush the might of death, proclaiming resurrection to all. Wherefore do we glorify thee, O thou, who alone art merciful and the lover of mankind. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Gabriel descended from his sublime height, wrapped in a white robe, and came to the stone where the rock of life was. And he shouted to the weeping women, saying,
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the
Lord. Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to our remembrance how all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, Lady the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, bless us and save us.
Trust in the Lord shall transcend all sorrows.
to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For holy art thou, O our God, who restest in the holy place, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Down before the
shall they offer bullets upon thine altar.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, through the intercessions of the apostles, O thou who art merciful, blot out all the multitudes of our transgressions.
Through the intercessions of the Theotokos, O thou who art merciful, blot out all the multitudes of our transgressions.
Have mercy upon me, O God, according to thy loving kindness, according to the multitude of thy tender mercies, blot out my transgression. Jesus, having risen from the grave as he foretold, hath given unto us life eternal and great mercy.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Visit thy world with mercy and compassion. Exalt the morn of Orthodox Christians, and send down upon us thy rich mercies through the intercessions of our all-immaculate Lady the Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner and Baptist John, of the holy glorious and all honorable apostles, of our fathers among the saints, great hierarchs and ecumenical teachers, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas and Myra and Nicaea, Spiridon and Prometheus and Nectarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our father among the saints, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy Bearer, Demetrius the Mercenary, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Venus the Wonder Worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius, the God Bearer of Antioch, Paralampos, and Eleftherios, of the holy, glorious, and great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Fulpinia, Marina, Periskeva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, and bright, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, who shone in the ascetic life, of Basil the Great, patron of our community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the holy and righteous Joseph the Betrothed, David the Prophet and King, and James the Brother of the Lord, the holy, glorious, and bright, victorious, proto-martyr Stephen the Archdeacon, the venerable confessor, Theodore the Brandon, whose memory we celebrate, and all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petition of us sinners, who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
protector was the one chosen. Thou art a carpenter's son, but also the brother of the Lord that built all with the word, O blessed James. What shall I say, seeing that the Lord testified, as a man after my own heart I have found David? David committed adultery and murder, yet God forgave him and glorified him above all the kings of Israel. He gave him the great grace to compose the most beautiful penitential prayers and to prophesy the coming of Christ. God designated Joseph to protect the most holy virgin and imparted him great honor in the plan of the salvation of mankind. The Apostle James is called the brother of the Lord because he was the son of the righteous Joseph the betrothed. James greatly loved Jesus, and according to the tradition, he traveled to Egypt with the most holy virgin and Joseph when Herod sought to slay the newborn king. By their holy intercessions, O God, have mercy upon us and save us. Amen.
Working a great wonder, the Master saved the people of old when he made dry the sea swelling water. And now he is born of his own will from
glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For he is holy.
Honorable Presbytery, the Diaconate in Christ, all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. And all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city and every city and countryside and the faithful who dwell therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For healthful seasons, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers, by sea, by land, and by air, the sick, the suffering, the captive, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Call into remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Lord God, save thy people.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady the Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
For thine is the might, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Blessed is the man who fears the Lord, the Lord.
again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
What house will you build for me, says the Lord, and what is the place of my rest? Did not my hands make all these things, you stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears? You always resist the Holy Spirit. Your fathers did so to you, which the prophets did not your own fathers persecute, and they killed those who announced beforehand the coming of the righteous one, whom you have now become betrayers and murderers. You who received the law as it was ordained by angels and did not keep it. Now then, they heard these things, and they were cut to the heart and ground their teeth against him. But he, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God, and said, Behold, I see the heavens open, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. But then he cried out with a loud voice, and stopped their ears and rushed upon him with one accord. Then they cast him out of the city and stoned him. And the witnesses laid down their garments at the feet of a young man named Saul. And as they were stoning Stephen, he called upon the Lord and said, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he knelt down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. And when he said this, he fell asleep.
Peace be to thee that readeth.
Glory to thee, O Lord, the God of all.
Spirit, one God. Amen. Christ is born. So, as the saying goes, cold hands, warm heart. So cold church, warm spirits, I guess. When sometime after Mother Teresa died, it came out, it was revealed that she struggled throughout her life and her ministry with doubt, and that her faith had some doubts to it. And this was really shocking or somewhat scandalous to people, which I never understood. I don't know about you, but I have doubts all the time. Really? Oh no, the priest has doubts. Oh no, what does that mean for me then? Because I certainly have them too, right? But it wasn't a surprise to me, not only because of my own experience, but because doubts are part of what drives our faith forward in a certain way. It's almost as though doubts allow us to update our faith. Update our faith. We believe a certain way when we're children. And that changes throughout our life, and it becomes updated. When you're a kid, you kind of do things like you do when you're at the stoplight and you're waiting for it to turn green. You know, 1, 2, 3, light change. Of course it doesn't change, but you're a little kid, you think maybe you might have the power to change it. And that's sort of how our faith is when we're immature. That maybe if I say this prayer, then the God will really come and perform the miracle, and then of course the miracle doesn't happen. And then in a certain way, doubt creeps into our minds and into our hearts. But that allows us to grow, and that allows us to mature, and we realize, well, that's not exactly how God works and how God operates, and that's not how he responds to us on command and on demand like that. And we grow. So doubts aren't necessarily a bad thing. And the icon of the Nativity, Joseph is shown being tempted by the adversary, and this is given to us to reflect this idea that he was doubtful and he was troubled. How could a virgin conceive? But his faith was guided and aided by the Holy Spirit, and it grew and it was updated, so that when it came time for the Christ child to flee to Egypt, he was prepared to go. And he had made the decision to stay with Mary and to protect her and Christ. And no doubt the journey was not a pleasant one. It's not as though they hopped in a car and drove in the air conditioning, things like that. But his faith grew to such that he was willing to care for the child, care for his mother, and to know who he was. So doubt in this particular case didn't prove to be fatal to his faith. And it shouldn't prove to be fatal to ours as well. But whenever we have those moments, we should say to ourselves, there must be something that I'm missing here. I still need God. I still need to grow. I still need to stretch and mature. And something needs to change with regards to my faith, and not just to chuck it, but to seize the opportunity. Speaking a little bit about Joseph, now we'll speak a little bit about David, whose memory we also celebrate today. King David was the greatest of all kings of Israel, and is the model and is a type of the kingship of Jesus Christ, in as much that he comes from his lineage, and he unites the prophetic roles, and he unites the kingship roles in himself.
shouldn't also forget that Melchizedek is also a type of the kingship of Jesus Christ. But David is another one who the world might look at like the world looked at Mother Teresa and was kind of scandalized by her doubts. We can look at David and we can be scandalized by the fact that he was not even close to being a perfect man. But as I said before, and you know from the scriptures, he's an adulterer. He is someone who takes his rival and sends him to the front lines so that he can be killed. And so he's, in that sense, he's called a murderer. So, what do we do with that? Especially if Christ comes from David. Well, we have to understand the great and deep repentance that David had. And that is essential for our salvation. So if doubts shouldn't lead us to reject our faith, then sins shouldn't lead us to reject our faith either. This happens sometimes. Someone will come and say, well, I haven't been going to church, Father, because I'm sinful. You and me both, buddy. But that's exactly why you should come to church. This is the place for sinners. This is not the place for righteous people. We don't have room for righteous people. This isn't the place for them because they don't need God in their righteousness. But this is the place for sinners. And so our sins should not keep us from God, but we should seize the opportunity and to repent. Not that we should go out and purposely sin just so that we can have an opportunity to repent. That's not what I'm saying. But when we wake up, then we can seize the opportunity, we can repent, and we can turn to God. Lastly, I'll say a little bit about the others that we commemorate today. James, the brother of the Lord, and we also commemorate the first martyr, the Archdeacon Stephen, and we also commemorate Theodore the Branded. Theodore the Branded. You know, there's some people that go out and they get brands to commemorate, I don't know, whatever they're commemorating. But they get brands on themselves. Well, Theodore was branded, but he was branded all over his face. And he was branded with insults from the emperor because Theodore upheld the faith and the importance and the place of icons in our church. And so the emperor to really inflict some pain and some insult branded these nasty verses all over his face. So when somebody tells you that the church historically has always been bound with the state, well, here's a great example where it wasn't. But also, James, the brother of the Lord, he was somebody who went on the journey to Egypt with Christ, which we remember today, and he also suffered for the faith, and he was martyred. And of course, the proto-martyr, Stephen, the archdeacon, he too was a martyr, obviously. What can we understand from the sufferings of these holy people? We have to be willing to suffer for Christ, and we have to be willing and courageous enough to do so, particularly in the small ways, because, let's face it, we're not really persecuted to the extent that these people were persecuted. Sometimes we have inconveniences, sometimes we're made to be felt a little bit uncomfortable in the workplace, or shut up when we're in public, and we can't talk about our faith, but nobody's branding us, right? Nobody's throwing us like they threw James or clubbing him over the head. Nobody is stoning us to death. So what do we do then? How do we understand martyrdom? Particularly because the martyrs understood themselves to be participating in the death of Jesus Christ. It was a baptism by blood, so to speak. How can we imitate their martyrdom when no one's out trying to stone us to death? Well, we can imitate their martyrdom by embracing the way of the Orthodox Church, and particularly with our fastings, with our prayers, and with our vigils, with our almsgiving, with going out of our way to show mercy and compassion. These are forms of martyrdom. So monasticism is understood as a form of martyrdom. Whenever we voluntarily However, we voluntarily take on sufferings, then we are becoming martyrs. Married people, you get a crown on your head when you're married. This is a way of martyrdom. You don't have to tell your wife, oh, you're killing me. But when you voluntarily submit yourself to her, when you voluntarily submit yourself to him, and you put your own will to death, then you are living a life of martyrdom. And you're growing, and you're stretching, and you are maturing. And in those moments, you'll absolutely have doubts. Absolutely. Was I supposed to marry this person? Does fasting really work? Am I really going to receive the grace of God by going out and giving alms because I've been doing it for so long and I don't feel the love from God? Doubts creep into our minds when we try to live the way of the martyr. But that's all right. That's all right. Because that just tells us that we need to grow a little bit more in some other respect. That our faith needs to be updated and needs to be renewed and refreshed. And by the grace of God and keeping our eyes focused on him, that will happen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let's offer the gifts on behalf of the whole world.
Help us, save us, and mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace, wisdom.
Guarded always by thy might, we may ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
President of the United States, and all civil authorities, and our armed forces in defense of peace and freedom everywhere. And the Lord God, remember his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
And for the servants of God, that they may have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and visitation, and pardon and forgiveness of sins, especially the priests Milton and Presbyter Connie, Deacons John, Brenda, Dolly, Julian the Simmerick family, Sana, John, Chris and the Brown family, Vespina, Clarissa, Jared, John, June, the Nuntekla, Jeff and the Eden's family, Joshua and Child, Julia and Child, Liz and Child. May the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. To the servants of God, departed this life in the faith and hope of resurrection, and unto life eternal, Metropolitan Philip, Bishop Antoon, the Archpriest Boniface, the Priest Matthew, Papadia Joanne, Papadia Stephanie, George, Agnes, Sylvia Jean, Thomas, and Russell, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. And all those that you yourselves are remembering, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us commend ourselves and each other begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all-holy and good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Stand with fear, let us attend, that we may offer the holy oblation in peace.
Thank you.
broken for you for the forgiveness of sins. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "Drink of this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins." And offering unto thee thine own love, thine own, in behalf of all and for all.
Again, we offer to thee this rational and bloodless worship, and beseech thee and pray thee and supplicate thee, send down thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts here spread forth, and make this bread the precious body of thy Christ.
Amen.
And that which is in this cup, the precious blood of thy Christ.
Amen.
Changing them by thy Holy Spirit. Especially our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady, the Theotokos, Ghost, and ever Virgin Mary. Among the first, be mindful, O Lord, of our Father and Metropolitan Joseph, and our Bishop Thomas, whom do thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth.
And of those who offer these precious gifts to the Lord our God, the honorable presbytery, the diaconate in Christ, and every priestly ordering of their salvation, of the peace and stability of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, the salvation and help of the people here present, those whom they are remembering, and of all mankind.
And all
now been spread forth and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That our God, who loveth mankind, receiving them upon his holy, most heavenly, and ideal altar, as a savor of spiritual sweetness, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Vouchsafe, O Master, that with boldness and without condemnation we may dare to call upon thee, the heavenly God as Father, and to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into
and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be to all.
And to my spirit.
Bow your heads unto the Lord.
Unto thee, O King invisible, who by thy boundless power has made all things, and in the multitude of thy mercy has brought all things from nothingness into being. Do thou thyself, O Master, look down from heaven upon those who bowed their heads unto thee, for they have not bowed down unto flesh and blood, but to thee, the fearful God. Therefore, O Master, do thou thyself distribute these gifts here spread forth unto all of us for good, according to the individual need of each. Voyage with those who sail by sea, journey with those who travel by land and air. Heal the sick, thou who art the physician of our souls and bodies. Through the grace and compassions and love toward mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy and good and life-giving Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. By thy mighty hand to impart unto us thy immaculate body and precious blood, and through us unto all thy people. O God, be gracious unto me, the sinner. O God, be gracious unto me, the sinner. O God, be gracious unto me, the sinner.
Let us attend.
The holy things are for the holy.
Divided and distributed is
the
Lord God.
Jesus Christ, to the glory of God. Amen.
thou exalted, O God, above the heavens, and thy glory above all the earth. Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Master, who lovest mankind, benefactor of our souls, for that thou hast vouchsafed this day to feed us with thy heavenly and immortal mysteries. Make straight our path, establish us in thy fear, guard our life, make firm our steps through the prayers and intercessions of the glorious Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary and of all thy saints. For thou art our sanctification, and unto thee we ascribe glory, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us go forth in peace.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
O Lord, bless us those who bless thee, sanctify us those who put their trust in thee. Save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Preserve the fullness of thy church. Sanctify those who love the beauty of thy house, glorify them in recompense by thy divine power, and forsake us not who hope on thee. Give peace to thy world, to thy churches, to the priests, to the civil authorities, to the armed forces, and to all thy people. For all good giving and every perfect gift is come from above and cometh down from thee, the Father of lights. And unto thee we ascribe glory, thanksgiving, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Christ our true God, through the intercessions of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, of the holy, glorious, and bright victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Basil the Great, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, and
Joseph the betrothed, David the prophet and king, James the brother of the Lord, and the proto-martyr, Stephen the archdeacon, and the venerable confessor, Theodore the branded, whose memory we celebrate, and of all the saints. Have mercy on us and save us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ our God, have mercy upon us and save us. God bless you and good morning.
Good morning.
I hope you all had a wonderful Christmas and Nativity. Good to see you all, even after such a short turnaround. It's always nice to see. It's a good sign. It's a good thing. By way of announcements, we'll have services Friday morning, I think. Whatever the first is. Is it Friday?
Yes.
Okay. We'll do matins and we'll do liturgy for the Feast of St. Basil, and we'll break some Vasilopita and hand that out as well that morning. And shortly after that, of course, we'll have Theophany. We'll be celebrating the Feast of Theophany on the evening of the 5th. And this year we're going to do something a little bit different. Normally, we bring the table up front and we have all these little individual bottles filled up. Well, for a whole host of reasons, we're not going to do that this year, not least of which because you have to fill up every single bottle. And then I always have people say, well, what do I do with these bottles afterward? Because there's an icon and holy water's been in it. I can't just throw it away, Father. What do I do with it? So we will encourage you to bring your own dispenser, or own little bottles. And we've bought a couple large 3-gallon water dispensers along with the silver one that we had in the back. And that's what we'll do. So bring your own dispenser. We'll fill them up. We'll bless the water and fill them up and go from there. So this will also save us some money in the long run, because you'd be surprised, those little bottles, although made in China, are not cheap. So God bless you. We have the little heater. It helped a little bit, because when I came in, you could see your breath. So it helped a little bit. And we'll keep that going, but pray that we've got a speedy end in sight to getting our electrical permit and getting our HVAC back up. I think that's all I have for announcements. Dasha, please.
Just reminding you, we'll check the house blessing.
Check the house blessing schedule, yep. Please do. Don't feed the priest. His Eminence asked us if we could just kind of be quick about our house blessings this year. And so usually I stay and I talk for a little bit. But I'll probably speed things up a little bit more to be mindful of everybody's health and so forth. So, other announcements?
Ender's birthday.
Ender's birthday. Hi, Ender.
Gonna be 2.
Nice. Good for you, buddy. Grant, O Lord, mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, and furtherance in all good things to thy child Ender, and preserve his life for many years.